What's up, my flavorless little watermelons? This is Rob from The Gay Guy Plays, and today on The Daily Grind, we're gonna be reworking Ember. Now, this all came about mainly because of the fact that as of late, I've been playing Warframes that I hadn't touched in quite a while. Whether it was because I didn't really like their playstyle, or there was something that turned me off about them, or maybe I just pushed them to the back of the closet and completely forgot they even existed. Now, one of those frames was Ember, and as you guys know, there was a very controversial change to her ultimate ability that really put people off of her. Me personally, it didn't hurt me that bad, but Ember was really never one of my favorite Warframes out there, and I really started to think, what would it take to get me on board with Ember, to really make me love Ember without necessarily changing her to the point that she becomes a completely different Warframe? Because I think that tends to happen whenever there's a discussion about reworking a Warframe. Everybody tries to turn that Warframe into something completely different, and I think that very strongly whenever they do a rework or they make changes to a Warframe, that they really should honor the original intention of what that Warframe did, but find ways to tweak it and make it work in the current state of Warframe. Now, one of the things that I really paid attention to was the fact that there were certain Warframes that were really great at evolving, because I think the big discussion about Ember is that she becomes really ineffective towards later levels of the game. And I think that one of the best Warframes that handles changes in late game is actually Rhino. And I know that's not necessarily a frame that we talk about a lot on this channel, but I always call it the end game switch. It's something that happens with both Nova and Rhino. When they are at lower levels, they're all about dealing damage and eradicating enemies. You know, Rhino can run around stomping and killing tons and tons of enemies at a time, and Nova basically just evaporates them. However, one of those things that we don't really get with Ember is that same kind of switch between damage at like early games and then really, really good CC or really, really good debuffs later on. So I figured that's something that we should definitely focus on. In addition to that, we've got new mechanics that have been added into the game that I think could really benefit Ember with some of the newer Warframes that have launched or some of the reworks that have recently happened. Regardless, let's just get all of that out of the way and just jump into what I feel would be the optimal way to rework Ember without necessarily making Ember a completely different Warframe. Because legitimately, if we just wanted to make a new Warframe, we could just make a new Warframe, right? So let's start off with her terrible, terrible passive. What is that garbage? She gains 10 energy per second and also gets a 35 power boost when she is set on fire. But within her kit, she has no way of setting herself on fire herself. And it's so specific. Now, I get that there are other Warframes out there that, you know, when they get struck or, you know, when an enemy attacks them or something like that, right? Then they get a benefit off of it. But the thing is, this is being attacked by such a very specific thing that I'm just like, it's so limiting. So what I actually went ahead and did is scrapped it, but kind of kept the same feeling. Now, Ember will regenerate a small amount of energy and health per second for every surrounding enemy afflicted by a heat proc, maximum of 10. Now, here's the thing. I left a lot of room to tweak this because I didn't name the energy per second, and I also put a max amount attached to it so that if DE did want to do something like this, they could find some numbers that were kind of like the Goldilocks numbers. They're like, all right, well, let's have it be, you know, 5 energy and 5 health per second and maximum of 10. So you can only get like 50 health and 50 energy, you know, for every second as the passive is live. So that way it's kind of like a way to balance it. I mean, they could lower it to 2.5, they could drop it all the way down to 1, depending on the way that the rest of her kit works. But I kept in mind with this passive that it should really tie in to the rest of her kit. So let's go ahead and take a look at that, because I think that this is a really interesting way to kind of promote Ember being offensive to keep herself alive and to also keep her energy stores up. So Fireball, as you guys know, is kind of like the iconic boring ability that all Warframes get. They get that kind of like single target slash small AoE ability as their first. And to be honest with you, the way that this would work with the kit is actually not half bad because of the fact that you throw this fireball down. It leaves a fire patch. Enemies that walk over it will get heat procced. And then that will go ahead and fuel your energy and health regeneration from your passive, right? So I was like, all right, we don't need to change it. But if I were to change it, and just putting that out there, I wanted to do something a little bit more interesting. So I actually created an ability called Living Fire. So what you do is you cover your enemy in Living Flame, and you know they are set on fire, so they get the fire proc, and then every second that that Living Fire is on them, it will actually attempt to jump to another enemy. So very similarly to Saren Spores, where it's kind of like you've got this infected target that starts spreading to other enemies, but instead of having to pop spores, this will just automatically happen. Now, of course, it's not going to be a big, crazy damage dealer like Saren's is, but basically what happens is you have this one enemy that's just spreading the fire proc to other surrounding enemies, and of course, those enemies will spread it to other enemies, and so on and so forth, for the duration of that ability. Now, I didn't want to go into anything much more crazy than that to basically try to turn it into Saren's ability. But the big thing about here is it's a great way to spread the fire proc to surrounding enemies to get more health and more energy back from your passive. In addition, it kind of acts as this passive CC that jumps around because enemies are constantly getting fire procs on them. Another aspect that I wanted to introduce here, which I think might be cool too, is that any enemies that die with the living fire on them will leave a fire patch on the ground. So that way you've got other ways to also basically cover the area in fire patches that could potentially trigger your passive. So that's definitely something that I wanted to go ahead and do that. It's like the CC version of Spores using the heat proc. Keep that in mind. Moving along, we've got Accelerant. Now, the big thing for me for Accelerant is it's very limited again. It's very focused on heat damage. And I get that they wanted to make heat damage a thing, but very similarly to how we were talking about Saren and the spreading of her first ability making it very useful, I wanted to kind of give some love elsewhere. So one of the things I'm going to be honest with, I couldn't give a crap about the casting speed increase that Accelerant provides. Like, I guess it's there. I guess it's nice so that you can refresh your world on fire. But legitimately, I was thinking that they should treat this very similarly to Saren's Contagion. Now, for those of you guys who don't know what Contagion does, I mean, Whiplash? Toxic Lash, whatever it's called. It's Contagion. To all of the veterans out there, it's Contagion. But before, Contagion only used to affect Saren's melee weapons, right? But now with her most recent rework, they actually made it affect her, all of her weapons, but her melee weapons get a larger boost. So I was thinking in my head, why can't we do the same thing to Accelerant? So instead of it just be fire damage, why not give the base Accelerant the ability to make enemies take, you know, 2.5 times more damage, which is the base of Accelerant, and then heat damage would be multiplied by 5 times. So you'd still get the whole, like, oh, we're stressing the fact that Ember is a fire damage based warframe and we really want to push that fire, but this way, her ability doesn't become just like this AoE stun that kind of helps fuel her ultimate and maybe a couple of her other damage based abilities, but it actually becomes useful on a wider scale. You know, now you're being able to debuff enemies, everybody can do more damage to them, and it's not just like Ember running the show here. Well, Ember barely running the show, because the heat damage isn't really all that great. So I think that's definitely a big thing that they could potentially leave for Accelerant. And then the other thing that I would like to propose, and maybe it's not necessarily a thing that they have to do, but I thought that there was a very interesting mechanic that they did both with Wisp and both with Garuda, was forced procs. Is that any enemy that has Accelerant, any damage that they take would be inflicted with the fire proc. As you can see, I'm really trying to push the passive here. I'm really trying to make it so that the passive synergizes with everything along down the line. So now they're taking more damage, they're being forced with heat procs, which will end up fueling her passive, which will give her more energy and more health. I think it's a great way to keep her alive because, in all honesty, you know, Ember is very squishy, but if she can use the fire to fuel her life, I think that's pretty dope. All right. So that's all I really have for Accelerant. I really think that they should make it a little bit more broader in scope. Moving along, we have Fire Blast. Oh, if I'm going to be honest with you, I kind of just don't give a shit about Fire Blast. So for those of you guys who don't use Ember very much and or have completely forgotten about her, this is the one that creates that ring of fire. With one of her most recent reworks, they made it so it acts similarly to Frost Snow Globe or to Eximus Auras, where they kind of like push back enemies and they'll knock enemies back, right? So a part of me is like, oh, okay, I get it. And then they also did the kind of Volt Shield treatment where if you shoot through it, you deal bonus fire damage, which is great because that messes with her passive again, fueling her passive, keeping her alive. But I don't feel like it does enough. I really don't. So I thought that it might be really, really cool if it acted very similarly to Mesa's Shatter Shield, where if you are standing on the inside of the Fire Blast Ring, basically any projectiles that travel through the Fire Blast Ring will just melt the projectiles. So what happens is you take, you know, less damage, and that will of course depend on the amount of power strength that you have on Ember. So that way, it kind of encourages you to use Fire Blast as not just like this, you know, offensive tool where you're leaving this ring of fire or just knocking enemies back, you know what I mean? I think that it's a really, really great tool to be able to keep Ember alive so she can kind of hold her ground in the midst of these flames, using the flames to melt incoming bullets. And the great thing about this is the fact that this synergizes really, really well for team play. So it's not just Ember, you know, being the star of the show saying, well, I only affect my fire damage because nobody else is really using heat damage out there with accelerant. So now I can use this to protect my allies. You know what I mean? Anybody who stands within the fire is gonna get damage resistance. And the thing is, damage resistance can be scalable. So it's one of those things where, you know, DE doesn't need to make this exactly like Mesa's Shatter Shield where it reduces, you know, 95% of the incoming damage, maybe, you know, 70%. Just a little bit of something to help keep her alive, and, you know, they can always tweak the numbers, but I think that there should be some level of damage resistance when it comes to standing inside the Fire Blast. And I'm gonna put this out there, just so that you guys are aware. This is something that is very simply done because they've done this with the Elytron. The Elytron can literally paint an area with these gas fumes, and then no projectiles get into that gas fume. So why couldn't we do it in such a way where standing inside would just reduce the damage taken? I think that it's great for team play. You know what I mean? It's a good strategy because you're granting your team damage resistance, but also granting that offensive boost where you're setting enemies on fire from inside because, again, it grants the fire damage, right? So you're keeping yourself alive, you've got some damage resistance in there, and, you know, you're kind of pushing enemies away. So I think that that's a great change to it. Nothing too crazy. Now, the last one, and I should have led with this because I think that people are going to be mad. I didn't do anything to World on Fire. I know I'm a sinner, and I know that there are so many Ember mains out there that used to love running around with Ember like blindly, just leaving that on and just eating through enemies in large areas. But I don't actually hate World on Fire in its state. Yeah, the range does kind of suck. But legitimately, at least for me, I kind of feel like it's where DE has intended for Ember to be. The closer you are, the more damage she deals, whatever. But the only thing that I did change to this is that World on Fire would have a synergy with, Living Flame. Because, like I was saying earlier, you know, like, we gotta have some synergies somewhere, right? So I was thinking that if World on Fire, because you know how Living Flame will, you know, produce another Living Flame every second? Well, if World on Fire hits something that has Living Flame attached to it, it'll produce a spark instantly. So whenever they're getting hit, anything is gonna do that, and then you'll just get more and more sparks. And then basically what ends up happening is you have a shit ton of CC flying around the place, you get some bonus fire damage off of it because of Living Flame, and anything that dies leaves fire patches. So now you've got World on Fire, where you're running around as this big old, you know, molten, I guess you can't say like world, but like this hallway of fire. And then you can leave all of these fire patches behind because it is encouraged with Living Fire, how Living Fire, whenever it kills an enemy, will leave a fire patch on the ground. You get more burning, you get all of that good stuff. That's just kind of like the way that I chime in on Ember. This way, Ember still feels like Ember, except she has more, what's the word I want to say? She has more relevance in later games via the use of her damage reduction, and then of course the fact that Accelerant can hit and amplify damage more than just fire. So that's my current standpoint. Let me know if you still feel like Ember feels like Ember, or if we just need another Fire Warframe. I don't know, trash Ember and start all over again. Toss your feelings down in the comments below. Let me know what you would do to promote some synergies, because I know I was sitting here and thinking, I was like, oh, well, what other synergies could we have with Fire Blast and World on Fire and Accelerant and all of that kind of stuff? Toss any additional synergies you would like to see down in the comments below, or if there's anything that you would want to see with Ember. I'm going to be honest with you, the second that I started filming this, I was thinking in my head, I was like, someone is gonna fucking say an exalted phoenix or some crazy bullshit where Ember turns into a goddamn firebird, isn't it? They always want exalted something. No, don't exalted me, okay? Regardless, that about does it for me for Neo. Now, Neo, leave all of your feelings down in the comments below. And as always, love somebody, hurt nobody, and touch yo body. I'll see ya, my flavorless little watermelons later. Bye-bye. They really don't taste like anything. Let's be real. It's just water. I mean, that's why it's called watermelon. Huh.